I'm talking about setting up a fab lab in a special condition. It's an innovation instrument for the government of a developing country. So I want to reflect on that, and that is based on my experiences with setting up a fab lab in Paramaribo, Suriname. I introduced myself already, so I can skip that. I will tell you a little bit about the background to have an interest in this topic. Three factors I think are important: the socio-economic context, the organizational environment, and the business case of the fab lab. As a background, we see that the number of fab labs is doubling every 1.5 years. So there were 50 only 3 years ago worldwide, and there are more than 200 now already. And the fab labs have many differences. They have much in common, but there are many differences as well. I want to stress these differences. A major one is that you see a big difference between the developing countries and the developed countries. There are many other differences as well: the building, the funding, autonomous or not, the target groups address, etc. But I focus on developing countries, and one of them especially Suriname. This is a map of Suriname. Its geography, it's 400 times 400 kilometers, 90% is tropical rainforest. It is in South America at the north coast. So you can walk to Brazil if you like, and French Guiana and Guyana. The population is very mixed, 500,000 people in total from various origins, about 7 different groups you can distinguish. But they are all mixed and living most of them living in the capital, Paramaribo. And there is where the fab lab is. What are the challenges of such a country? Well, of course, there is a lot of beautiful tropical rainforest that is exploited for gold by gold diggers and mineral extraction. It has to be preserved. High-tech can be used everywhere. And there is no maker industry. And the boys are leaving school at 13 and become a taxi driver at 18. And that is not a good future for the country. So in this case, we have a fab lab. And that is a policy instrument for the government. That is nice. You have extra visibility. But it is also uncertain, because you never know how long the policy will be maintained. Further, we are part of the cabinet of the vice president. That is interesting, we are close to the center of power, but you are also part of a bureaucratic organization, and that is not such an advantage. Here you see the machines. And we also are located in the government building. That means that high-level visitors are introduced to the fab lab very easily. You simply receive a warning almost 30 seconds in advance, and then you have to prepare for such a visit. But it's also a barrier for free and open access. In principle, everybody can come, but you should not come on your slippers, for instance. The business case is, there is an initial funding, and also for the coming years, but you never know, and we want to have to attract volunteers and fab nomads from other fab labs. That's not the case yet. But you never know how long the funding will be continued. It's a decision of the parliament. The organization asks concrete output figures: how many opening hours, how many visitors. While it is more interesting to look at how many informed citizens do we have, how many new businesses are coming out of the fab lab, and what are the long-term effects of the fab lab. So we all always have to stress these differences and try to measure how we can reach that. Well, we do that by our systems approach. First of all, we have here presented a short scorecard of our fab lab. You see the vision, the material base, the expertise and the services, and the current state. And it is clear that especially the field of expertise, full-time staff, well-educated staff, is very important for us to work upon. Our systems view is oriented at the humans and at the knowledge. The human system means that we are working in three different ways: introducing people for a one-time visit, facilitating the tinkerers and the individuals, and ultimately working for new businesses. We want to convert one category into the other, and we need to keep track of figures, how many people, how many visitors become thinkers, how many thinkers become new entrepreneurs. Also, knowledge management is much more important in our case than in the regular Fab Lab. It is not only the Fab moments that have to be archived and distributed, but we want to generate a stream of new information into the country. Well, in the next time, we want to continue with this process. We want to learn also from other Fab Labs in same conditions. And of course, we think there is such a wealth of information about what Fab Labs are doing and how Fab Labs are thinking about what they want to contribute to the world, that a lot of new scientific research is needed to learn from what we are doing and to improve our functioning in the near future. This is what I had to offer to you at this moment. I would like to thank you and invite you to come and visit us in the beautiful country of Suriname. It's a direct flight from Amsterdam and 9 hours. It is a Dutch-speaking country with for the people from Western Europe low prices to stay there, and it's always, the weather is always as nice as it was here last week. Thank you very much.